Hello, everyone, and welcome. My name is Carl D'Souza. I work on the FastTrack team at Microsoft. We are part of the engineering team, and I'm a solution architect. Today, I have with me Dan L. Halawani. Dan, you want to say hello?
Hi, everyone. Yeah, I'm Dan. Nice to meet you. I'm an architect on the FastTrack team here with Carl, and I'm very excited to be here.
Awesome. So, Dan, you built a control, I heard, that is going to be really useful for users of field service. And that's to do with the schedule board, something about copying schedule boards. Is that right? You want to tell us about it?
Yeah, absolutely, Carl. Yeah, thank you. So this control, it's a PCF control that allows you to copy a given schedule board tab. In field service, if you're familiar with the schedule board, you know that we can have a number of tabs that have different settings on them. And sometimes it will be advantageous to take an existing board that's different than your default board, make a copy of it, and just change a couple of settings. Maybe only a few minor tweaks need to happen. Right now, that's a little bit of a tedious process, but this control makes that a lot easier.
Very cool. Very cool. I'd love to see this, Dan. Do you want to show us this, share your screen out? And yeah, I can't wait to see this thing. Looks.
I would be glad to. Absolutely.
Exciting.
Absolutely. Yeah. This is the control here. And so we host this in a model-driven app called Field Service Extensions. And this app and the source code will be available on our GitHub repository that we'll talk about briefly here. But we host it in this app here that hosts this full page control that allows you to do this functionality. And it also hosts a link out to the schedule board so you can validate what you've done.
Very nice. Very nice. So let me clarify here. So you built the app. The users can easily use this app, but if they wanted to, they could actually take the control and put it in their environment anywhere they wanted, right?
That's exactly right. Yes, that's exactly right. This app is kind of a nice one-stop shop to quickly use this control and this functionality, but absolutely correct. If you wanted to host this in your own app, this is just a full-page PCF control, so you can host it in whatever model-driven app you'd like to.
Very cool. Now you got me excited, Dan, because you said the words PCF control, and I love PCF controls. So you built this as a PCF control. Yes. Do you happen to have the source code that anybody could use by any chance?
I do. Absolutely. So right here, this is our FastTrack implementation assets GitHub repository for Microsoft. Okay. And we host all of the source code out here for this control, as well as the solution to just bring in that field service extensions model-driven app that's kind of the one-stop, already-ready shop, right? And so the solutions directory here, we have that nice unmanaged solution all ready to go. But if you're more developer-y and you like PCF control work like Carl, you can pull down this source code and modify it to your heart's content.
I love that. That's great. Very nice. And by the way, this repository that we have here has a lot of FastTrack assets that are very useful for other projects. So if anyone's listening, head out to this GitHub repository. You're going to see tons of stuff to help you with having a successful implementation, really. That's what all this is about. Okay. So great. So Dan, you put the assets into this this repo. Anyone can pull it down. They don't have to be a developer because they can install the solution directly into their environment. But if they are a developer and they want to get their hands a little dirty, maybe change the source code a little bit, you have the source code here so they can clone it, make changes, and then push that up to their environment as well if they want, right?
Exactly right. Exactly right. It's all located here. Feel free to use it as you'd like to. And then we do walk through some of the finer points of the board and some technical details, including installation details for both methods down here as well. Okay.
Fantastic. Very cool. Now, I'm really excited to see this thing in action. Do you want to give us a little demo?
I would love to. Yeah, absolutely. Okay, so let's walk through the UI of this control first, and then I can talk a little bit and demo some of the functionality going on here and why it does what it does. Okay, so from a UI standpoint, you can see here we have a dropdown, okay, of schedule board tabs. These are schedule board setting records on the back end. So we just show a list of them here so you can pick from them. Some customers have 50, 100 boards. So this makes it really quick and easy to pick the board you're looking for. Okay. And then from a settings display perspective, we do enumerate all of the settings. Because like I said, each schedule board tab is a schedule board setting record with fields. And those fields define the settings for that given board's tab. So we do enumerate that down here. We try to show as much information about that schedule board tab and the settings aligned to it as possible, whereby if you're familiar with these concepts, you can map certain views in a schedule board tab. Well, we show the GUID for that, but we also show the name because that's pretty helpful and handy to have, as well as certain color designations. And then a couple of larger points on here are that there are some fields on this record that are JSON-based. You can see them here on the screen. We do enumerate that out. We parse out the JSON. We do a little bit of formatting on it to make it look a little nice and readable. And then you can scroll through here and look at the individual settings that are contained within this JSON, which is usually a fairly tricky or annoying endeavor. Otherwise, we just show it right here so you can get an understanding of what this board exactly is doing. So that's the UI side of this board. But let's talk about some of the functionality that this board does, okay? So for example, let's say I wanted to take an existing board that I have, make a copy of it, and then just change a couple of things, just a couple small things on it, okay? What would I do? Well, there's a copy board button here, and also there's some information for anybody coming in new to the control. They can just look right here and find out what each of these buttons do. But let's say we wanted to do that save as, that kind of copy functionality. We click copy board here, and then we can type in the name of our copy and hit submit. And so it will create that copy. Now you can see I have it in the list here, right? And you can see the settings down here. If I go back out to my schedule board, you'll see that it's a legitimately new tab out here, okay? And so now that I've made that copy, I can go to the board settings out here and change just the couple of settings I wanted to change. Maybe I just wanted to change a couple of colors here, but nothing else. Well, I can do that here, save it, and it's done, okay? So that's wow. That's the meat of the functionality here. But we do a couple of other things as well, just to kind of make things a little easier and add a little bit of extra functionality and value to this control. So we do allow you to disable a board. And what does that mean? Basically, on the back end, it's just deactivating the schedule board settings record. But if I click it, you'll see something happen when I go back to the board. I'm going to disable this board, and then I'm going to go back to my schedule board. You'll notice that it's no longer here. So let's say you just wanted to hide a board. Well, you can disable it, and it's hidden. And you can bring it back if you ever need to, okay? And we can see that in the UI here. I could re-enable it if I wanted to re-enable it, and it will show back on my schedule board, okay? We Very do cool. also allow you to delete the board here. Of course, that's functionality that you can see in the schedule board tab as well, but wanted to make a little bit of a one-stop shop. So if you didn't mean to make a copy or you don't need a given board, you can just go in here and delete the board directly there, right? It'll prompt you, and then you could submit it. We won't delete this one since we're using this for our demo purposes here, right? But you can do that from here. And then there's one final piece of functionality that's pretty valuable, I think. And it's this ability to pop the schedule board form into a new tab, into a new window here. Okay. Now, why is that valuable? Well, if you have a given schedule board tab that you are sharing out to people. So let's say, for example, in our board settings, right? I had this shared with specific people, right? Well, right now, what you have to do to share that out is you actually have to go to our old advanced find, open up the record from there, and then use the share button to share that out, okay? But we do have some updates and enhancements coming to our settings app in Dynamics 365, and it won't be showing that old advanced find anymore. So it would be nice to have folks have an easy way to get to this form and be able to do the normal expected sharing functionality to share the board with the people that need to see it. So with this button here, we allow you to pop it into a new tab, share it out as you need to, close the tab, and you're done.
Wow, this is very impressive. Now, let me ask you some questions here. You deleted a board. Can you delete like all the boards, or is there like any restrictions there?
Good question. Good question. Yes, there are some restrictions. So for example, let's take our default board that every org has, every environment has this board, right? And it's important to the functionality of the schedule board. If I hit delete on here, we block that. You can't delete the default board. Okay, that, and that also applies to our resource utilization view as well. It doesn't let you delete that. However, if you're so inclined, the source code is out here. And so if you'd like to modify it to remove that control or play around with that, please go ahead and feel free, with caution, of course. But yes, natively, we do block some of those things that could be problematic.
Very cool. Okay. And I was kind of wondering, as you're doing this, so let's say this control didn't exist and I wanted to copy a schedule board as a user, right? How would I do that? Can I do that?
You can do that. You can do that. There's a couple of different ways you could go about it. The most common way that people will do is they will just create a new board out here and then set all the settings manually, right? Set everything here as they need to have it displayed. Okay.
Really a copy, right? That's just a, you have to do it from scratch, right?
It's not. It's a very manual copy. Yeah, it's a very human powered copy. Absolutely. Right. So it gets pretty tedious to have to essentially replicate all those settings. Maybe you have your old board on the left and a window with your new board, and you're copying all the settings. That can get very clicky, especially if you need to do this across multiple boards, right? So this is how you do it traditionally. Now, of course, there are ways to copy the board via an API for more advanced users if they wanted to do it that way. But that's not the path that most folks go down. And from a UI standpoint, it does get a little clicky, right?
Right. Yeah, okay. So you would have to build something custom through the API. There just unfortunately isn't a button that says copy out of the box. But that's the problem that you've solved here, right?
Correct. Exactly. Exactly right.
Wow. Okay. Very cool. Very cool. This is very fast as well. I noticed, like, when you click copy board, it really literally just copied it in like half a second, you know, so that's a very cool functionality.
Absolutely. Yeah. It is a pretty quick call, and it tries to be performant about all of its operations. So yes, indeed.
Great. Okay. And so just to clarify again, so if you want to install this in your environment, you don't have to be a developer. You can literally just pull down the solution from the FastTrack GitHub and import that solution like you would do any other solution, and it'll appear in your environment, and then it'll have the app as well, the model-driven app. So you can use it from there, or you can just pick up the component and put it any way you want, right?
That's exactly right, Carl. Yep, absolutely. In our solutions directory here in our GitHub repository for this component, we host a simple unmanaged solution that shows exactly what I've been showing today, the field service extensions app, the control, and the link to your existing schedule board. So you can just download this, import it into your test environment, and go to town.
Great. Excellent. And I guess one point I probably want to mention here is this is really a sample code, right? So we want users to absolutely try this out, but, you know, try this out in a lower environment, a dev environment, really. But, you know, this is something to be used probably with just a little bit of caution, right? We don't really support this, but we want you to have this functionality. Is that a fair thing to say?
That's very fair. Exactly. Exactly. Good. As with anything, always test in a lower org. Make sure you're comfortable with the functionality at play. If you want to change anything, like Carl said, we host the source code out here so you can do that. And if you want to see how the component works on the back end, you can take a look at the source code and understand that. But absolutely, we'd like for folks to use this as a jumping off point to do things that they would like to do to enhance their schedule board management.
Great. Yeah, I think there's a lot to be learned from this. You know, I can't wait to look at this source code myself and take a look and kind of see how this fits together, because I'm kind of thinking this thing could be extended, you know, for a particular use case, let's say, you know, if you're an organization.
Absolutely. Yeah.
Great. Well, thank you so much, Dan. This is very impressive and very excited to see this. So thank you so much.
Absolutely. My pleasure, Carl.